Good morning, my dear students. We are back with our lecture. I hope you all have enjoyed your Diwali vacation. Yes or no? Have you enjoyed your Diwali vacation? Yes, with lots of fun. Am I right? So now let's start. Now it's time to study. Let's start our lecture. In the last, till last, we have learned the heat lesson and motion and time. In physics, we are going to start with the next lesson. Already you have learned this lesson in the class 6, that is electric current. Am I right? In the class 6, you might have learned the electric current. Yes or no? We have discussed in this electric current, we have learned how the circuit works, what is meant by the torch, electric torch, how we can maintain the safety. Yes or no? This all the points we have done in the class 6. In class 7, we are going to learn related electric current in little bit deep. We are going to learn little bit deep. So electric current and its effect. In class 7, we are going to learn electric current and its effects. What are the effects on the when we are using the electric circuit? Are you getting? So there are, if you will go through your book, you will just see there are the two students, that is Paheli and Pooja. Yes or no? These two students, they are doing something innovative work. They are preparing the electric circuit. When you are doing something innovative and when you get a positive result, when you are doing any kind of the electric work, electric circuit, and if it is successful, in the class 6 we have done the electric circuit, that we have prepared one, we have taken one cell and we have taken one bulb and we have, with the help of the switch we have on that bulb. Yes or no? With the help of the switch we have on that bulb. So they were so excited. This was a new experience for these two students. Yes or no? And they were so excited to find out how the bulb glows. So as they were excited, they decided to share this experience with the families, with the cousin. Yes or no? You are also, when you are excited, when you are doing something innovative, something different from regular schedule, and if you get any success, then you are very excited to share that things. Similarly, these two students, Paheli and Pooja, are very excited to share their experience with their cousins, with their other family members which are living in a different town. So they as if you might have seen the circuit which they have prepared this circuit. So if you want to see the circuit, in this there is a cell, there is a pin, there is a key and some wire and bulb. Am I right? This is the circuit which they have prepared, and after preparing this circuit, they have found that bulb glows. Then how it glows, they were so excited to find this. Am I right? And as they were trying to draw, these two students were trying to share their experience. So how to share the experience? So they tried to draw the diagram. They tried to draw this all the diagram in on the page, but it was very difficult. It was very difficult to show the cell, battery, the pin, then there is a key. It was very difficult to show on the page. So they started to find, is there some easier way to show this component? Yes, there is an easier way to find this, to draw this component in a simple way. That is, we use the symbols to draw the electric circuit. To draw the electric circuit, we use the symbols. So there are the different symbols to draw the electric circuit. Now in your book, there are some symbols which are given in the table. In the table 14.1, in the table 14.1, the symbols are given. So related through that we can draw the circuit. It will make it very easy to draw the circuit. Now you might have seen the C. How is the C? It is like this. When I given on the same, that is one is plus and another is minus. This plus indicates the positive terminal, while this minus indicate the negative terminal. This plus indicates the positive terminal of a board, of a battery, of a cell. This indicates the positive terminal, while this indicates the negative terminal of a cell. So this, how we can represent in the symbol? We can represent this in a symbol like this. One as a straight line, long line, longer line, and one as a shorter line. This longer line indicates the positive terminal, while the shorter lines indicates the negative terminal. Are you getting? So this is the symbol for the C. So this is a symbol for the C. The positive line is indicated by the longer line, and by the shorter line indicates the negative terminal. So there are the different symbols for the electric components which is given in the table 14.1. For example, the cell, we can indicate this sign. One is longer and one is short, that is positive and negative. That is the bulb. To indicate a bulb, we can use this symbol. To glow any kind of the bulb, we need a switch. So switch is indicated. This is on square switch. This is on. And if you want to show that if the switch is off, then we have to show like this. This is the off. Then wire is indicated by drawing a line, a vertical line. Then we need a, so for every, if you will see, the every instrument does not work only on the C. They need a battery. We have learned the torch. Am I right? In the class 6 we have learned the electric circuit of the torch. In a torch we need the battery. Am I right? We need one or, so what is actually the battery? So what is a battery? See, just see and you will tell me what is actually the battery. Which is this symbol? Just tell me which is this symbol. This is the symbol of a cell. Am I right? So, and this again, positive, negative, cell. This is also a cell. It means the battery consists of one or two more cells. The battery is nothing but a combination of one or two cells. That is called as a battery. Are you getting? Battery is nothing but a combination of one or two cells. Then you might have seen that every cells are not always connected. See, when we want to connect the cell, we have to connect the positive. The next cell, if there are the two cells, if we want to connect these two cells, then how we can connect this positive terminal? This is a positive, this is negative, then negative, this is positive, this is negative. Then if you want to connect these two cells, then we have to connect this by a wire in a such a way that negative terminal should be connected to the next terminal of the positive terminal of the cell. Are you getting this? So, and every cells are not connected in a series. In some cases, they are connected one after another. Am I right? Like this. Am I right? The cells are not connected in every instrumenters faces are not connected always in a series. Series means what? This is a series. Are you getting? Well, if we want to connect in the series, then this positive terminal, this is negative, positive, negative, positive, negative. When we are connecting the another cell, then we have to connect, this is a negative terminal, opposite charges we have to connect, the opposite terminals we have to connect one after the another, then only your circuit will get complete or it can work successfully. Now if the series is like this, then how we can connect the cell? How we can connect it? In such a case, if the cells are connected one after another, then there is a metallic wire which is used to connect this positive. This is the positive, this is negative, positive, negative, positive, negative. If you will connect this positive terminal to the positive, the circuit will not complete or the connection will be not be proper. It will not work successfully. So this positive terminal is connected to the negative terminal. See, this is the positive terminal which is connected. It will connect to the negative terminal. Then next, this positive terminal will be connected to the negative terminal. Are you getting? This will be the circuit. This will be the actual circuit. We can say this circuit is complete. Are you getting? The positive terminal is connected to the negative terminal of the next cell. Positive terminal of this terminal is connected to the next cell of negative terminal of the next cell. So like that, this connection is done. Are you getting? So this combination of one or more cell is called as a battery. The connection should be like this. The positive terminal of the one cell should be connected to the negative terminal of the next cell. Are you getting? So this is how the symbols for the battery. Are you getting? So for every electric components, we need a symbol so that we can draw in the circuit diagram. I mean, it will make a very easy to draw in a circuit diagram. In the class 6, we have learned one more concept, that is the always. If we want a circuit to be complete, then we use a switch. For example, now see, in the class 6, we have done one connection, that is, see, this is a cell. Then the cell is connected to the bulb. Okay, then we need a switch. When we can say the circuit is complete, when the switch is on, then only the bulb will glow. Am I right? When the switch will be on, then only this bulb will glow. Am I right? So switch is very important. So how we can represent the switch? We can represent the switch by the symbol in the scene. This is on switch. This is on. And if you want to show the switch is off, then we have to draw this like this line. So this is off switch. Are you getting? This is off switch. Are you getting? So when the switch is on, then only the bulb will glow, and when the switch is off, the bulb will not glow. Are you getting? And we have learned about the in a bulb, what is there? Yes, filament. In the bulb, what is there? There is a filament which helps the bulb to glow. Are you getting? So this is the filament. If the filament will break, if the filament of the bulb will break, whether the bulb will glow? No, the bulb will not glow. Are you getting? So If you might have observed the bulb, are you getting? If you might have observed the bulb, after some times when you will try to touch that bulb, the bulb might have become a hot or a warm. Why is it so? You just tell me, why is it so? This is because of the effect of the electric current. Because of the effect. Which effect? That we will learn in the next video. In today's work will be that you have to just read all the concept and try to draw the symbols of 14.1 in your physics notebook. Thank you.